Hello, creators! Today we will learn two ways of editing patterns in 2D and 3D windows. I have a basic t-shirt from the modular configurator that I prepared for editing in the previous video. Watch and follow it or download the project file with ready-to-use patterns. Links in the description. Our goal for today is to turn these basic patterns into oversized drop shoulder shirt. I prepared the Pinterest board for you so you can check what we are doing. It's very important to have some references to see how the garment looks in real life to make it realistic in 3D. During this and next videos, we will be making such a hoodie step by step, learning tools, properties and features of cloth. But the first step is to make the shape. Drop the shoulder, make the bodice and sleeve wider and adjust the length. So let's get back to cloth and start with 2D editing. First of all, I want to delete these red notches. We need them for pattern making to match fabric pieces when sewing, but we don't need them for 3D modeling. We have a special tool for it in a 2D toolbar, Notch tool. Select it. Then select all the notches or press Ctrl A and press Delete. We will use Z Edit Pattern tool for moving edges and points. For example, we need to make a long sleeve wider, so we need to extend the side edge. I don't need the segment point on my way, I would rather have a straight side seam, so I will delete it. Now, if you select and move the line, the armhole will not move. But if you do box selection, covering the armhole area, you will be able to move the side edge together with the armhole. So select and move it right. Press and hold Shift to move it exactly on the X axis. You can see small numbers that show us the line length and the distance we move them. So you can move it by an approximate value or right-click and type the exact value. Let's extend it by 6 cm, for example. Repeat this action for the back pattern. Delete the segment point and extend the side edge by 6 cm. By the way, worth mentioning that my goal is to show you how we can edit patterns in order to create a realistic 3D model, not sewing patterns for production. So it's not a pattern making lesson. Now let's make the armhole bigger. You can see that it's too high, which is unnatural for this kind of tweed shirt. So we need to drop it somewhere here. Select both front and back underarm points and move them down to about 6 or 7 cm. We will see changes in a 3D window only when we finish moving points in a 2D window, so it can be a bit hard to figure out how far you need to move them. Later I will show you another tool that can be easier for moving lines and points, but I recommend you to practice with 2D editing, it gives you more control and possibilities. The next step is to drop the shoulder. Select the point and move it diagonally. You will see the pink line that will guide you. Follow it and move the point by about 8 cm. Do the same on the back and simulate. Now we need to widen the sleeve. Press Shift Z to see the line length and try to match the cap to the armhole, front to front and back to back. For example, I need to make the back segment bigger, so I grab the point and move it to the right, so it roughly fits the armhole length. No need to be too precise, because we are making a 3D model, not sewing patterns. Real clothes always have defects like uneven or stretched seams, some distortions and wrinkles. I think that a 3D model becomes realistic when we add some imperfections to it. So we can intentionally make our sleeve bigger or smaller and check how it looks in a 3D window. Great! Let's hide these baselines so they don't get in our way. Here you can find icons that turn on or turn off the visibility of different lines, threads, pins, etc. I will turn off showing us baselines. Well, I think we can drop the shoulder even more and make the sleeve wider. You can continue editing patterns in a 2D window, but I'll show you another method, using the Styline tools in a 3D window. Edit, Scale, Move and Draw. Let's select the Edit Styline tool and click on the garment. The main feature of these tools is that we can move points and lines on the 3D garment and see where we move them. At the same time, you can see the changes on the 2D patterns. Also, we move a point or a line on all patterns simultaneously. So when we move the shoulder point, it changes its position on the front, back and sleeve. We don't need to move it separately on each pattern, as we did it in the 2D window. However, it can be a problem if you want to edit only one side. Then you need to go back to the 2D window and make changes there. Let's move the shoulder point down a bit and also drop the underarm point. The shape of the sleeve cap becomes a bit curvy because we move only underarm points and the top segment points stays in place. We will need to fix it manually in a 2D window, but it's not a big problem. Generally, it's a good practice to check what is going on with your patterns in a 2D window and fix them if needed. Of course, you can leave it as it is, but this is too big a defect for me and it looks unnatural. So let's fix it quickly in a 2D window. Press V, Edit Curve Point tool, and move these curve points. Just to make the process quicker, delete most of them. I leave 2 points on each side. Then move them to make a natural smooth line of the cap. Maybe move the top point up a bit. Yeah, it looks better. And match the cap length to the armhole again. Here we go. Great, we have the shape. The next thing is to shorten the length of our bodies and sleeves to have the space for ribbon cuffs. Let's use Move Styline tool for this. Click on the garment and move the hems up and down. I think it's the easiest and quickest way to move edges and hems. You can do the same in the 2D window, but it will take a little more time, especially to shorten the sleeves. It tapers towards the bottom, and you will need to do at least 2 steps to achieve the same result as with the Move Styline tool. I mean, you will need to move it up and then widen it, or you can also move each point individually along the side edge. If you want to make some lines longer or shorter, you can use the Scale Styline tool. For example, we can widen the sleeve opening. The bodice looks good to me, so I will not touch it. What I want to make is to drop the center back point so the back will be longer than the front. I will use the Edit Styline tool and move it down. By the way, when you move the point in a 3D window, Claw adds some curvature to the line. You can see it on the 2D patterns. But if you move it in a 2D window, it doesn't. So it's another big plus to the Styline tools. Also, I want to move the shoulder point to the front a bit, so we can see the shoulder line from the front view. Here we go. Basically, we made the shape for our hoodie. But while we are here, the last thing I want to show you is the Draw Styline tool. You can use it to add new lines to your garment, or rather cuts, because Claw will cut and sew the pattern along this line. This is a really cool tool for designing and experimenting with your style. You know, since I was a pattern making before, I'm used to working with 2D patterns only, but then I discovered 3D editing tools and realized how useful they are. You can easily add new style lines to the 3D garment, and you don't need to guess where to draw them on 2D patterns. Then you can easily move and find the best location for them, and even create a completely new style. However, these tools have some disadvantages. For example, I didn't find a good way to widen the bodice, the action we did at the very beginning. Also, you can't edit only one side of the pattern. Sometimes you need to fix patterns in a 2D window afterward. But generally, they are really powerful. Anyways, try both methods to see what works better for you. I recommend you to use 3D editing in conjunction with 2D editing. That's it for today. We made an oversized shape for our future hoodie. I will go back to the previous version, the one we have before adding new style lines. You can access it from the history window. This one, I think. I will add a link to the final version as well. Check the description. In the next video, we will add realistic ribbed cuffs, learn how to make layers, and adjust seam lines. See you there! Bye!